Dear students, welcome to this short video on the overview of the course 16x64 Analog and Mixed Signal IC Design. What is analog? Everything we see, hear, and perceive in life is analog. Examples are voice, music, seismic activity, visual perception, voice recognition, energy conversion and transfer. All electronic systems must interface with the world via analog electronics. Therefore, study of analog circuits with a design perspective is very crucial in electronics and communication engineering. Department of IS and RV College of Engineering offers various courses in the broad area of VLSI design. The foundation course is Basics of Electronics Engineering or Elements of Electronics Engineering in first semester of your engineering. From third semester onwards, we are offering courses in both analog and digital streams of VLSI. In third semester, we offer analog microelectronic circuits under analog stream. Analog microelectronic circuits covers the design and analysis of discrete analog circuits. You are familiar with this circuit. This is the circuit of a common source amplifier. The working of MOSFET, BJT and amplifiers using discrete elements are dealt in this course. This is a rigorous course which lay the foundation of analog IC design. The next course in analog stream is 16EC64 Analog and Mixed Signal IC Design. This course is divided into 5 units where we cover the design aspects of analog as well as mixed signal circuits. The first unit is review of analog design where we teach various models for analog design followed single stage amplifiers. The 3 useful configurations of a MOSFET, common source, common drain and common gate amplifier circuits are discussed along with designing these amplifiers from a given set of specifications. This will be followed by cascode unfolded cascode amplifier circuits, which are 2 important circuit techniques in the design of operational amplifier. After the discussion of single-stage single-added amplifiers, differential amplifiers were covered. The inherent immunity to noise is the key feature of differential amplifiers. The analysis of differential amplifiers can be done easily by applying half-circuit concepts. The second unit starts with a very important circuit called current mirrors. Current mirrors are the basic building block used in IC biasing. This course discusses on advanced current mirrors such as cascode current mirrors. High output impedance is one of the important characteristic of current source, which is achieved using a cascode current mirror in integrated circuits. Current mirrors are followed by operational amplifiers, which form a crucial block in almost all analog ICs. Various architectures like telescopic op-amp, folded cascode op-amp, two-stage op-amp and gain-boosting op-amp were discussed in this unit. All the configurations were designed from a set of specifications. The design knowledge of operational amplifiers are really important for an analog designer. Third unit starts with the stability of analog circuits. Stability of op-amp circuits are discussed with frequency compensation techniques. Today's analog designers constantly deal with the problem of noise because it trades with power dissipation, speed and linearity. So learning about noise will be really helpful in the design of analog circuits. Third unit also discusses about noise in integrated circuits. Unit 4 deals with band gap references, which are the important circuits used to generate reference voltages in ICs. Switched capacitor circuits were also discussed in this unit. Last unit, Unit 5, gives an overview about ADC and DAC fundamentals. ADCs and DACs are the crucial interface blocks which connects analog and digital world. A few architectures of DACs and ADCs are covered, which includes current steering DAC, successive approximation ADC and oversampling ADCs. The objectives of learning this course are: design basic amplifiers, differential amplifiers and current mirrors using MOSFETs. Design different op-amp topologies for a given specification using CAD tools. analyze stability of op-amps and apply the appropriate compensation technique. Analyze amplifier circuits by considering noise effects and design and analyze sampling switches and switch capacitor amplifiers. The course is designed to cover in 44 lecture hours. After completing the course, the students will be able to apply the knowledge of MOSFET and amplifiers to investigate various design trends of analog IC design. Analyze the functionality of analog, mixed signal circuits and systems. Design and implement analog integrated circuits. Evaluate the different performance parameters of analog, mixed signal integrated circuits. This course will take you to the first 5 levels of Bloom's taxonomy, where you will be able to understand the amplifier architectures, apply the knowledge to review various literatures, analyze any given amplifier circuit, design it for a given spec and to evaluate the design using any CAD tools. The reference books for the course are Design of Analog CMOS Integrated Circuits by Behzad Razavi and CMOS Circuit Design, Layout and Simulation by R. Jacob Baker. The figure shows the basic difference between an analog and digital signal. You would have learned in your signals and systems class that analog signal is continuous time, continuous amplitude signal, whereas digital signal is discrete time, discrete amplitude signals. Now, let me ask you this question. World is going digital, why analog? Because analog links real world to digital world. Physical signals are analog in nature. Digital signals have higher noise immunity and ease of storage. So interface, condition and process analog signals. Let us look inside an iPhone 7 chipset. You can see significant number of standalone analog modules such as ADC, DACs, oscillators, phase locked loops, power management circuits. The courses in the department of IS will cover almost all sections of this chipset at a reasonable depth, so that at the end of the program you will achieve a good mastery over all these niche areas. Analog design process is very interesting and challenging. Everything starts from brainstorm ideas that leads to design of block level system as well as component level circuits. After verifying the simulations, layout will be done. That leads to fabrication of IX, followed by packaging, testing and debugging, prototyping and characterizing the IC. This can be later developed as an evaluation board or can be commercialized. Why do we have a passion for analog IC design? It is challenging. Analog circuits are sensitive to private noise, etc. It is a creative process. No unique logical method to design a circuit. It must be insightful and intuitive. It is state-of-the-art work. A challenging and satisfying career is available at analog companies. These are some of the analog companies recruits analog designers. AMS faculty team of Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering wishes you a good time of learning. God bless you. Thank you.